All right, what's up, guys? Ibra here with Hardware. What are you doing? Oh, come on! What's? Are you kidding me? Guys.
One more thing.
This is only good for taking notes, man. Jeez. You know what? Forget about the sponsored stuff. You know, I have something more exciting, which is this right here. The 3950X. Let's do it. We've all been waiting for this day, and so have I. In fact, after a lot of teases from AMD, we're finally allowed to talk about the Ryzen 9 3950X's performance. Now, I'll be honest with you guys, I'm super excited about this processor because it offers a ton of cores and threads, but most importantly, it feels like it hits the final nail in the coffin for Intel's high-end crazy pricing. That's because the 3950X goes for around $750 while offering 32 threads on the X570 platform. Now that platform is a lot more affordable compared to X299, and it offers a lot of features compared to Z390. So why don't we get into the performance results? Spoiler alert, guys, this CPU is really, and I mean really fast. But is it $750 US or almost $1,000 Canadian worth it? Let's find out. But first, a quick message from our sponsor.
We've all been there looking at that RAM thinking, what a weakling. Well, no longer.
Introducing TuffRAM by Thermaltake, the toughest RAM around. With a discreet built-in logo and premium heat spreaders design, the toughest addressable LED system with super brightness, compatibility with all the usual motherboard software, even Razer Chroma, and voice control through Amazon Alexa. Available in the toughest capacities of 16 GB per kit with speeds between 3000 and 4400 MHz.
Consider the TuffRAM RGB, link below.
All right, so I'm gonna get into benchmarks, but before that, I do wanna talk about the processor and what it's about, just in case if you missed our coverage of it. This CPU has 16 cores and 32 threads, which equals the Threadripper 2950X, but it also operates at much higher clock speeds too. Other than the smaller cache size, the 3950X uses the AM4 socket and X570 platform. The only thing it really lacks is the Threadripper's quad-channel memory support. Compared to the 3900X, it has 8 more threads and higher max boost clock, but the base frequency is also quite a bit lower too. TDP is also the same. The issue for some people might be pricing, because the 3950X goes for 50% more than the 3900X, so don't expect the same amount of performance uplift compared to that processor. I think you're really paying a premium for having the fastest AM4 CPU on the planet. Now, I do want to be perfectly clear about this CPU. AMD isn't targeting this for gamers whatsoever. In fact, it's really meant for content creators or professionals who would love to accelerate their workflow without investing huge sums of money into platforms like X299 or X399. So with that out of the way, I think it's time to get into the performance results. Now, I do want to mention that we have replaced our testing procedure. In fact, we've eliminated a lot of these synthetic benchmarks and we've replaced them with more real-world use case scenarios. So let's get into it. Generally, all of our test systems are the same. They're using 32 GB of memory clocked at 3600 MHz, a GTX 2080 Ti, a Corsair MP510 2 TB SSD, and a Corsair AX860 IPSU. All motherboard specific enhancements were disabled too. For cooling, a Noctua NH-U12S heatsink is always used, except for X399 and X299. Those are cooled with the Noctua NH-U14S. Let's start off with Cinebench, and right away, wow, the 3950X blazes ahead of pretty much everything, guys, even the 9980XE and the previous generation Threadripper. Cinebench R20 conveys the same story too, with the new Ryzen 9 leading everything. Single core benchmarks show that AMD has made huge improvements with their lightly threaded performance. That's really good news, since most professional apps and games don't fully stress all CPU cores all the time. So that's it for our synthetic test, but now we're gonna move on to some real world benchmarks, and I think this is where it gets even more interesting. Starting off with Blender, and it really does show how good AMD's new Zen 2 architecture stacks up against the super old Skylake X architecture used on the 9980XE. Remember, this is a 32-thread AMD processor, literally tied with an Intel CPU with 36 threads. I'm just gonna let that sink in for a second. MetaShape is a new program for our benchmarks. It's used for taking thousands of digital images and combining them to create a 3D data. Basically, it prefers a combination of core counts and higher sustained clock speeds, and that's why we see the 9900KS so competitive But once again, the 3950X wins. Even in Reality Capture, which is a program that's a lot like Metashape, since it also takes a ton of image data to compile multi-dimensional images, it's super CPU intensive and the 3950X is impossible to beat again. It even puts the Threadripper 2950X to shame, and that is impressive, guys. Now, this test is actually one of our most CPU intensive, since in it, we're building a version of Firefox for Windows, which processes through more than 10 gigabytes of data. Here, the 2950X wins out by a bit, since its memory bandwidth and cache give it an edge. The 9980XE is pretty competitive too, but not for a CPU that costs way more than $1,000. Handbrake is a pretty solid test for multi-core video transcoding, and here, the Threadripper dominates again. But look at that. Look at the 3950X. It beats the 9980XE again. Intel should be pretty worried by now, guys. Premiere Pro is an interesting program since it uses the IGP in Intel's Coffee Lake CPUs to accelerate rendering. So the 9900K and KS end up on the top, but the 3950X ends up being the fastest non-accelerated CPUs here. In DaVinci Resolve, the 9900K gets another narrow win, but that's because nearly all of our CPUs are slightly bottlenecked by the graphics card. Just take that into account before you assume a super expensive Threadripper bill will get you better results. Right, Dimitri? All right, so now on to gaming performance. Now, I'm gonna go through these really quickly, but there's one thing to keep note of, and that is we've ran all of our tests at 1080p, but the gap between the CPUs could narrow if you step things up to 1440p or 4K. That's because the GPU would be more of a bottleneck compared to the CPU. In all of these games, the results are pretty close together, but you can actually see that the 3950X is pretty competitive, but the 3900X is actually a better, less expensive option if you're building a gaming-focused system. The main reason for that is the 3900X was able to maintain higher overall clock speeds in most titles, and while it wasn't by all that much, the difference did end up showing up in the charts. Another thing that's interesting is AMD has almost closed the gap with Intel when it comes to gaming performance, even when compared to the 9900K series. They're not quite there yet, but seriously, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference with your naked eyes. Now, something I really wanted to mention is a bit of an odd claim from AMD that the 3950X was optimized for liquid cooling. And I'm gonna say this right now, that's just marketing BS, because you don't really need an all-in-one liquid cooler to cool this processor. Let me explain. As you can see, our Noctua U12S with a single 120mm fan was able to easily keep up with the NZXT Kraken X62 when cooling the 3950X while it was under full load. So unless you're looking for more RGB goodness, I'd recommend you just stick with a very good air cooler. Switching over to power consumption, you can actually see the 3950X's overall efficiency is a big reason why its temperatures are so good. All things considered, when the CPU is fully loaded, it consumes about the same amount of power as the 3900X, and that's pretty impressive, guys. All right, so I think it's time to wrap up this video. I am genuinely blown away by what AMD was able to deliver with the Ryzen 9 3950X. I mean, they literally bought Threadripper-like performance to the AM4 platform for a fraction of the cost compared to their higher-end CPUs. I mean, sure, $750 is not cheap, but it offers an amazing value for content creators or other folks who love taking advantage of all of those threads and chewing through their particular workflow. But I also want to take a few seconds to talk about Intel, because they are in a lot of trouble. I think AMD might have purposely sandbagged their early results by comparing the 3950X to the 9920X, because this thing is actually competing against the 9980XE, a processor that was going for a ridiculous $2,000 just a few months ago. This new AMD processor has basically devalued Intel's entire high-end desktop lineup. And I'm talking about the upcoming Cascade Lake X here, not the current CPUs. The $1,000 Core i9-10980XC is only supposed to be a few percent faster than the 9980XE, but that processor was spanked by this guy. And that's a very big problem. So I guess the last thing that needs to be accomplished by AMD is to make sure that this processor is available to buy in stores for $750, because from what we've been hearing, there's gonna be very limited quantities of this CPU, and that could potentially lead to price gouging, and yeah, that could be pretty bad. But otherwise, this is all I've got to say to AMD. Bravo, just well done. You've earned. I think this is amazing. This is just, yeah.